Dilapidated schools.
Okay, dilapidated school does not exist suddenly from these few months. Alright? It is a result of a 55-year neglect by the Barisan National Government, which this the GPS was part of it. Alright, but let's focus more on the recent event. Alright? In 2016, Najib went to one of these rural schools and then saw the school was in so bad shape. So he said, okay, I allocate 2 million alright, to build IBS via IBS system to build rebuild the school. 2 million each school. There are 6 schools benefited, so 4 million. Fair enough. Alright, that is 2016 January. And 2017 June, 1.5 years later, Michael Main announced that there were 1,020 dilapidated schools with 415 critically dilapidated school condition. All right, so he was also proposing to combine these some schools together, right, to save costs. But at that time, his cost of repair of these schools were estimated at about 1 million per school, which is he was quoted in the papers to say that they need 4 billion to repair and replace these 415 schools. Okay, that is 10 million per school. His projected estimated cost. Okay, when he went to then, that was 2017 June. In 2017 October, and that's where the announcement of budget. It was announced 1 billion for the dilapidated schools. And when that announcement of 1 billion was made in 2018, Anwar Rapi'i claimed that this amount will only be enough for 50 schools. 1 billion for 50 schools, 20 million per school now. Right? 20 million per school. Within 3 months, the cost of repair suddenly shot up double. Okay. And later on, this year, July. Alright, July. Michael Main was there. I think Anwar Rafi'i was there also. They make an announcement that the state government is allocating certain amount to replace or rebuild certain schools, dilapidated schools. Okay. And that was for SK Ulu Segan Bintulu and SK Maludam Betong. Alright. The allocation, the projected estimated cost is 40 million per school. Alright, for Ulu Segan is 40.1 million. Maludam is 48.2 million. Alright, from the initially 2016, Najib's allocation of 2 million per school to repair this dilapidated school, it went up to 10 million, estimated by Michael Mai, and then it went up to 20 million. And now, when actually the fund is given, it is announced, it is 40 million per school. And I've checked the number of students for SK Segan. It is only 235 students. Is it justifiable? 235 students, you spend 40 million. All right, 40 million. I think that's why my call in DUN is very clear message. We all want schools. We all want the best schools for our students. But do not treat projects to build school as your ATM machine for these BN cronies. Don't treat school building projects or any government projects as your ATM machine. I think that will not be allowed by the government, by the new government, federal government. All right. Another very perplexing. Okay, perplexing figures that I highlighted there. You see, the whole thing is that Michael Mai Ying in 2017 June announced that there's 1,020 dilapidated school with 415 critically dilapidated schools. That is June 2017. Yes, 2 days ago, Abanjo in his budget speech, he mentioned the same figure. You mentioned the same figure. This is a budget switch. 1020 dilapidated school, I just wonder where has the 500 million that was in the what earlier on allocated, where has it gone to? Right, or they're just trying to enlarge the figure and try to bluff the federal government into giving more fund. Okay, I think there must be certain amount of accountability and integrity in the implementation of government.